Sunday. And when we get to the communion, I will share with you how we use these communion cups that are at your seat. Let us now begin our worship with the call to worship. O Redeemer God, as we gather in worship on this World Communion Sunday, we ask that you send your Holy Spirit to fall afresh on us.
We pray for your Spirit to awaken new hope in us.
Grant us the vision to see the coming of your kingdom.
Help us to celebrate the glimpses of grace that you have given to each of us.
Knit our hearts together in worship and communion so that we know we do not struggle alone in working for your peace and justice.
We pray this in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ. Amen.
And God spoke all these words, "I am the Lord your God, who brought you out of Egypt, out of the land of slavery. You shall have no other gods before me. You shall not make for yourself an image in the form of anything in heaven above, or on the earth beneath, or in the waters below. You shall not misuse the name of the Lord your God, for the Lord will not hold anyone guiltless who misuses his name. Remember the Sabbath day by keeping it holy. 6 days you shall labor and do all your work. Honor your father and mother so that you may live long in the land the Lord your God is giving you. Murder. You shall not commit adultery. You shall not steal. You shall not give false testimony against your neighbor. You shall not covet your neighbor's house. You shall not covet your neighbor's wife, or his male or female servant, his ox or donkey, or anything that belongs to your neighbor." When the people saw the thunder and lightning, and heard the trumpet, and saw the mountain in smoke, they trembled with fear. They stayed at a distance and said to Moses, "Speak to us yourself, and we will listen. But do not have God speak to us, or we will die." Moses said to the people, "Do not be afraid. God has come to test you, so that the fear of God will be with you to keep you from sinning."
On this World Communion Sunday, give us eyes to recognize your reflection in the eyes of Christians everywhere. Give us a mind to accept and celebrate our differences. Give us a heart big enough to love your children everywhere. We thank you for setting a table with space enough for all of us. Amen.
Tribe of Benjamin, the Hebrew born of Hebrews, as to the law. Take my life and let it be consecrated, Lord, to Thee. Take my moments and my days, let them flow in ceaseless praise. Take my hands and let them move at the impulse of Thy love. Take my feet and let them be swift and beautiful for Thee. Take my voice and let me sing, always only for my King. Take my lips and let them be filled with messages from Thee. Take my silver and my gold, not a mite would I withhold. Take my intellect and use every power as You choose.
Here am I, all of me.
take my feet and let them be swift and beautiful for thee. Take my voice and let me sing always only for my King. Take my lips and let them be filled with messages from thee. Take my silver and my gold, not a mite would I withhold. Take my intellect and use every power as you choose.
Again, he sent other slaves
more than the first. And they treated them in the same way. Finally, he sent his son to them, saying, "They will respect my son." But when the tenants saw the son, they said to themselves, "This is the heir. Come, let us kill him and get his inheritance." So they seized him, threw him out of the vineyard, and killed him. Now, when the owner of the vineyard comes, what will he do to those tenants? They said to him, "He will put those wretches to a miserable death and lease the vineyard to other tenants who will give him the produce at harvest time." Jesus said to them, "Have you never read in the scriptures, 'The stone that the builders rejected has become the cornerstone'? This was the Lord's doing, and it is amazing in our eyes. Therefore, I tell you, the kingdom of God will be taken away from you and given to a people that produces the fruits of the kingdom. The one who falls on this stone will be broken to pieces, and it will crush anyone on whom it falls." When the chief priests and the Pharisees heard his parables, they realized that he was speaking about them. They wanted to arrest him, but they feared the crowds because they regarded him as a prophet. This is the word of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
Tonight, with things that are happening and where we are as Methodists, as Christians, locally, but also as part of a global religion, I have come around to add a few things in and all of that. So let me begin with our religion as Methodists. We pray for our president and his family and all those members of government in this pandemic. And there are lessons that we can learn through what is going on that pertain exactly to what we are taught by John Wesley in Methodism. John Wesley tells us, "Do no harm. Do no evil." But that everything that we do and say, how we move and act, should be for good, for the good of the world. In fact, he gives us a whole big section in our Book of Discipline about our actions as part of the world and part of our community. So with all that is going on, what came to mind is, how can we do no evil? How can we do good the best we can in all ways that we can? And that would be to listen to the science of what is going on, to wear masks. This is not only to protect us, it is to protect all those around us. To protect the weak and vulnerable, the elderly, the young. It's such a little thing that we can do that brings such an amount of good. Staying distant like we are. And washing our hands and keeping ourselves clean, which is why we have the hand sanitizer in the back. These are little acts that mean so much for the good of the world. And now in our World Communion Sunday, what we are reading here, and we'll read in our, as we get to our prayer of thanksgiving, is how everyone is included in God's kingdom, how everyone is a member of God's creation, have the kingdom of God attainable to them through the grace of God. Paul's letter to the Philippians, he's writing about how he had everything. He was a Pharisee, he was a leader of the Jewish people, the temple. He was rich, he was well thought of, he had a reputation. He was even doing what he thought was right. His name was Saul at that time, and he was out for the church, rounding up these new Christians, throwing them in prison or even having them killed. And he thought all that was just. And we didn't read about his experience this morning, but on the road, when he was chasing the Christians, he was struck blind by God. And he was told to go, actually someone else came upon him, and they were supposed to bring him to their home. You imagine God asking that of you? Someone who's there to prison you or to kill you, bring them home. But he followed God's will. Saul went with him. And by being with the family of Christ, his eyes were opened to Christ's teachings, to the Word of God. And he became one of the, I would say, most prolific disciples of Christ. He went and started churches all over the Mideast and that Asian basin. So what he is writing here to the Philippians is how he had everything, riches, power, and how he lost all of that by becoming a Christian. And yet he says he doesn't miss any of that. He welcomes losing all. That's pretty, I don't know, if, you know, would we do that? Would we give up everything we have to follow Christ? Well, we here sitting today are following Christ. And yet what we get through following Christ is everything and riches and spirit and grace and what we really need. The parable that Jesus told, it's quite a bit harder to follow and actually put into a sermon. It's a little bit demoralizing, isn't it? The owner, everyone he sends is put to death, and how is this a good message? But what comes as he's telling the Pharisees and scribes, this is what they had done. They had kind of been absent from the lives of their flock, of their members. Yet they were supposed to be reaping all the goods and riches from these people that they had just gone off and abandoned. And he's saying, so the fields and the harvest and all of this will revert to the people who are doing the work. That's us. We're the laborers in the vineyard. We're the harvesters that harvest the fields of God's planting. And we are the ones that will reap the rewards. And as Paul said, he was also talking to the church about acceptance of everyone. It doesn't matter when you came to accept Christ. He was much older. And a lot of the parables that we've heard about the workers, who some that came on at 3 o'clock in the afternoon got the same pay as those who had worked all day, because it doesn't matter when we come to do God's work. We are all rewarded equally. And as Paul was saying, it's not only for, he mentions he was circumcised, which means he was Jewish. And some churches were saying, we are only here to give Christ to the Jews. And Paul would tell them, no, we accept all. We accept the Gentiles. We accept Romans. We accept anyone who is willing to lay down their life and follow Christ. And that's where we are in our lives. As we go out into our communities, we don't pick and choose who should know the message. We say, this is who I am. By your example, you are making disciples. And it doesn't matter who, of what religion, race, country. This is global. God's word is global. God's creation is global. It doesn't have any strings attached. Available for all, as it is available to us. So as we will now, well, in a moment, celebrate our communion, realize that it's the world's communion, that this meal that Jesus has presented to us is for everyone who accepts Christ into their lives. Then let us be in prayer. Lord God, we value your creation, of which we are a part. We know that you hear us, even in our silence. You also hear us as we raise names before others to hold dear in your loving care. Be over all of your creation, that we may do honor to you and that we may do no harm but do all the good for all the people wherever we can, whenever we can. And that you are guiding all those in power. You are guiding all those who are caring for us and our needs, the doctors, the first responders. That you are with those, no matter what their need is, whether it is comfort for the lonely, healing for the sick, whether it is your loving arms around those who are depressed and need to feel your presence, that all man and womankind are comforted under those wings of that mother hen that you are, being held close, guarded, guided, nurtured, and that they will feel your love surrounding them at all times. And now let us join in the Lord's Prayer as given to us by our Christ. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day your daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Yeah.
front of you is the communion service for World Communion Sunday. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is right and a good and joyful thing, always and everywhere, to give thanks to you, Almighty God, Creator of heaven and earth. You have made from every nation and people to live on all the face of the earth. And so, with your people on earth and all the company of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Holy are you, and blessed is your Son, Jesus Christ. By the baptism of his suffering, death, and resurrection, you gave birth to your church, delivered us from slavery to sin and death, and made with us a new covenant by water and the Spirit. He commissioned us to be his witnesses to the ends of the earth and to make disciples of all nations. And today, his family in all the world is joining at his holy table. On the night in which he gave himself up for us, he took bread. He blessed it, gave thanks to you, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat, this is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." And then after the meal, when the supper was over, he took the cup, gave thanks to you, O God, gave it to his disciples and said, "Drink from this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." And so, in remembrance of these, your mighty acts, in Jesus Christ, we offer ourselves in praise and thanksgiving as a holy and living sacrifice in union with Christ's offering for us as we proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died, Christ is risen, Christ will come again. Pour out your Holy Spirit on all those gathered here and on these gifts of bread and wine. Make them be for us the body and blood of Christ, that we may be for the world the body of Christ, redeemed by his blood. Renew our communion with your church throughout the world, and strengthen it in every nation and among every people to witness faithfully in your name. By your Spirit, make us one with Christ, one with each other, and one in ministry to all the world, until Christ comes in final victory and we feast at his heavenly banquet. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in your holy church, all honor and glory are yours, Almighty God, now and before we partake. We each have, I'm going to try and buy larger ones. There is a little clear plastic on top. Your Dorothy, would you like this one? Or can you get that?
It's coming.
Okay. There's a little clear piece on top, which we will remove.
Oh.
Yeah. And then that's the wafer. And then you remove the pink piece. And that is the cup. So may we all together partake in the body of Christ given for us. Did we all get it yet? It's all right. I'm only able to do this because I did it in the other church this morning, or else I'd still be here trying it. Did you get it? Okay. Isabel, are you all right there? Okay. I'm going to cut this out of our filming and do a thing in a minute here to put on the web. All right, so I have here the body of Christ given for us, the blood of Christ shed for us. And we do have a garbage can at back. You can throw those out on the way. I will also do it here for the film. The bread of Christ given for us. The blood of Christ shed for us. Go bravely and boldly into this world of confusion and pain. Bring God's healing words of love and forgiveness. Know the power of mercy and grace in your life, and use those wonderful gifts to serve God by serving the people. Go in peace.